Our next speaker is quite the character. Some people smile when they get embarrassed. If this is the case, then David is always embarrassed. I have never seen this guy go a minute without smiling. And he is always only a phone call away when you need a serious pep talk. Well, I say phone call, but he is always up for a lunch date too, especially if it has anything dealing with a Chinese buffet. And if you aren't hungry, then you can always catch him at any LSU home football game throughout the season. And let's not forget his love for agriculture. In only a few years, he will be giving these special pep talks to his very own ag students and FFA members. Please join me in welcoming, with his retiring address, unhindered, your state sentinel, David Cambry.
As long as I've known David, I've noticed this. He's not the type of person who walks into your life, says hello, and then walks away. He makes it his goal to leave his everlasting impact on the lives of every person he meets, including mine. To me, he has become more than a state officer. He's become someone who is there for me when I need someone to be there for me the most, and someone I can talk to about anything. And that is the definition of a true friend. He's not just that, he's my best friend.
You may know David as your state sentinel, but I know him as my older brother. He is always working hard and doing his best. He loves being in FFA and being with his team members. He has always encouraged me to become a leader because he sees potential in me. He impacts many people's lives and is always caring for other people. To me, he's more than a state officer. He's someone I can talk to, my brother and my best friend. I know that I can always count on him and that when I need him, he will always be there for me. I am honored to introduce your 2015-2016 State Sentinel and my brother, David Cambry.
We can all remember looking at superheroes and thinking, man, I want to be that person one day. Many of us would look at superheroes like Batman or Superman. But the superhero that I wanted to be was Captain America. Whether it was being on the front lines or fighting away swarms of enemies, he was always courageous, never letting anything get in his way. Whether it was him looking cool with that iconic shield while saving the day, or him not being hindered, Captain America possessed special qualities that allowed him to be great and to be a hero. You may not believe it now, but so do all of you. Now, you may not have the same heroic qualities that Captain America does, but you do have special qualities that allow you to live a life unhindered and to be great for others. Will you live a life with no fears but aspirations of being great for others, never letting anything get in your way? In World War II, an individual by the name of Calvin Graham possessed the same special qualities that I saw in Captain America. He exemplified what it meant to be courageous and never letting anything get in his way. Now, at the age of 11, he had hatched a plan to trick recruiters into allowing him to join the military. He started shaving so that he would be able to serve. Now, I don't know about all of you guys, but at the age of 12, I was not worried about shaving. All I was worried about was when the next episode of SpongeBob was coming on. However, Calvin was determined to serve in the military. He had passed all of his tests except for one, the always loved, never dreaded dental exam, a place we all loved, right? Who am I kidding? That place was terrifying. But for Calvin, it was a place of opportunity. It was a place where he would trick the dentist into allowing him to enlist and to be able to join the military and fulfill his dream. He was soon sent to basic training, which took a physical toll on his young body. He became a gunner on the USS South Dakota at the age of 13 and was soon sent into enemy territory. His ship took over 42 enemy hits, knocking out the power, but Calvin never left his station. At one point in time, Calvin was thrown three stories down from strap metal from the attack, but he got up. He helped others get to their feet and went to fight against the enemy. This was his way of not being hindered. He fought to join the military, and he fought courageously against the enemy for his country. But most importantly, he did not allow adversity to hinder him in any way. Now, you may not be a gunner on a warship, but you do have opportunities in life to be courageous. In life, you will be faced with bullies or people that will try to bring you down. But you must persevere and be courageous. In life, you will be faced with learning new things about yourself or getting outside of your comfort zones by taking that step to grow as an individual. If you do this, you will live up to your full potential. Now, do all war heroes have to carry a shield or shoot at the enemy to be a hero? My grandmother wasn't a war hero, and she did not need medals to be a hero each and every day. She was the type of woman that always had a smile on her face. And her way of being unhindered was through her faith and positivity. She was like a second mother to all of us. She would do anything and everything for anyone, regardless if she knew them or not. But one day, she wasn't feeling too well. So she went to the doctor and got a CAT scan, and many other tests ran, and they all came back with the same result. She had been diagnosed with lymphoma cancer. Many of us at this point in time in our life would have asked the questions, why me? But she didn't. She stayed determined to serve others, whether it was cooking, leading her Bible study, or a Sunday school class. She always stuck true to who she was, making her an everyday hero for us and our community. Although she eventually lost her battle of cancer, she never called it quits. Always pushed forward and enriched the lives of everyone that surrounded her. Now, just as she was being faced with her battle of cancer, in life, you'll be faced with many situations. In life, you can allow those things to hinder you, or you can take that step forward, like my grandmother did, and live up to your full potential and allow you to exemplify what it means to live a life unhindered. I was fortunate enough to have crossed paths with an individual named Josh. Josh had a heart of service for others and would do anything through small acts of kindness. Now, we often get too caught up in the big names like Captain America or Calvin Graham, but we forget to look at the stories like Josh. One day, Josh was walking through the halls, going to his locker, looking at pictures of his dad, whenever a group of students begin to ridicule him. Little did they know that he felt alone and he had been missing his dad because his dad had just passed away. He described his actions of walking through school as walking through empty space. He often would sit alone at lunch, thinking to himself that school was not a place that he belonged. He was so caught up in being the normal kid rather than being the extraordinary one that he could have been. But one day, Josh decided to make a change. He decided to start opening doors for others. But this brought on a whole nother set of problems. People began to call him names like the doorman and ridicule him. But Josh did not allow this to hinder him. People over time began to get used to him and would actually look forward to it. Through his act of kindness, people began to open up to him. And they even would do anything and everything for him. He describes opening doors as much more than a physical act. It's putting yourself out there, getting outside your comfort zones, and letting others feel welcome that there is hope. Now, everything was going great for Josh, and life could have stopped right there, and it would have been great. But Josh decided to take it a step further and became a public speaker. He had students come up to him and tell him that he changed the way that they expressed themselves and felt about themselves. This was Josh's way of not being hindered by becoming that public speaker and by exhibiting what it means to be unhindered through his small acts of kindness. In life, you will be faced with hindrances or things that may bring you down. In life, you will be given many chances to open doors for others. Whether it's a smile on your face or through your service, you can exemplify what it means to live a life unhindered by possessing those same qualities that we saw in Josh. In life, you'll be put into difficult situations that may make you feel as if you're hindered. Being hindered can be defined as anything resulting in obstruction, delay, or getting in your way from living your life. Hindrances can be anything from a loss of a loved one or bullies at school. You will have the choice to allow these things to get you down, or you can rise up and do something extraordinary. Now, I want each and every one of you around this room to ask yourself this question. Am I living a life unhindered each and every day? For those of you that are going through situations, will you allow those things to hinder you? Or you look at the stories of Captain America, Calvin Graham, my grandmother, or Josh, or the stories in your own personal lives and experiences? Will you let those things hold you back and hinder you from what life it has in store for you? The choice is yours. You can leave this convention saying that I will be hindered from what society and people throw my way, or you can leave this convention living a life unhindered. Louisiana FFA, let's choose to live a life unhindered.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls inside my brain. I was screaming loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm all right song. My and I'm chasing sleep.
David, our team has had the joy of getting to know you this year. From your numerous phone calls trying to see how speeches are going along, to you holding the door open for literally everyone, your kindness has never ceased to amaze us. Although we may not agree on which hometown strawberries taste better, we never have a hard time deciding which restaurants to eat at. You are going to do great things in life, David. And just know that the eight of us are only a phone call away. Louisiana FFA, your 2015-2016 State Sentinel, David Cambry.